Hey, it's Martin from Yes, I'm a Designer. Let me show you the 5 best new features introduced in Illustrator CC 2019. I have to start with my personal favorite, the freeform gradient feature. So we know that we had the linear and radial gradients available before, and we also had the gradient mesh option, which I have here, where you can select these control points and move them around on the mesh and adjust the gradient. But now we have, in the new version, the freeform gradient feature, which you can get to through the gradient panel. And as you can see, there's that option that wasn't available before. And I'm going to demonstrate this on a new shape. So I just have this shape prepared here and simply click on freeform gradient from the panel. Once you do that, you immediately get these control points. And all you have to do is to select these points and move them around. Now you can see immediately that we get the live feedback and they are adjusting really nicely, showing us the result. Of course, you can double click on these control points and then you can update the colors that you have selected. So you can even pick completely different colors here. And of course, you can click to add new points. And you can also increase the spread of these points. So you can have more of that color or less of that color. And what I love is that finally we have also the eyedropper with which we can select colors from additional parts of our artwork. So that wasn't available before for gradients. Now it's finally there. So once again, double click and there's your eyedropper. You can still rely on your swatches or your colors. And of course, you can also control the opacity of these points. So that's still available for freeform gradient. But one last thing that I would like to mention here before we move on to my next pick is that you can also use lines as an option. Now you can continue a point that you already have and draw lines as soon as you selected lines from the options bar or control bar on the top or from the gradient panel. And then you click and create your new path. And this is automatically going to create a curved path, similarly to how the curvature tool would work. So this is brilliant when you want to define the outline of a shape and you want to add shading. It's just extremely useful for character illustration, for example. But let's move on. The second feature I wanted to show you is the global edit. This is another huge time saver if you have multiple instances of the same shapes in the illustration. Like here in this case, if I select this tree on the left, I can see there's a few similar shapes here. But if I want to edit all of them at once, and I didn't use something like symbols, this would be a very complex and difficult task to do, and I would probably have to repeat the same steps over and over again. Luckily now in CC 2019, now all we have to do is to simply click on Start Global Edit here on the right side, and that automatically finds all the matching shapes in the artwork. If I make any changes to this shape, for example, selecting that point there and dragging it out, all the other instances immediately update. Even the ones that have different colors on them, or smaller, or even the ones that are flipped, like this one here. So once again, if I drag this all the way out, you can see how different it looks on all the different versions. But because their outlines were similar, Illustrator can still find all of these instances and update them all at once. How cool is that? That's a huge time saver. Especially if you have a complex Illustrator file with lots of instances of the same objects. But moving on, let me show you a more complex file with lots of artboards in it. And here is an amazing new feature called Presentation View, with which you can just get to focusing on artboards and very quickly flick through them, similarly to the presentation mode in InDesign. Here in Illustrator, the shortcut is Shift F. Once you are in this mode, you can use left and right arrows on the keyboard to toggle through your artboards. And this is great to see differences. So if you have multiple versions or different flavors, in this case for these packaging design that I have here, I can compare the ones that I created and see what's the difference between them. Or when I have the client sitting next to me, I can use this mode to very quickly run through all the versions that I created. Another brilliant new view as well here in Illustrator CC 2019 is the trim view, which helps you to preview your final artwork without the bleed edges or any of the details that's outside of the artboard boundaries. So to get to this, you just have to go to the view menu and choose trim view. Immediately you can see that we have a final version here. And if I want to get back to seeing everything again, I just have to turn off the trim view. There's no shortcut for this by default, but you can set a custom shortcut for it from edit keyboard shortcuts if you want to. The fourth favorite improvement for me in this version is less a feature and more like a general improvement in performance. And that is when you are zooming in and out, Illustrator will immediately create a raster preview of the current view or zoom ratio, and when you let go the zoom, it will switch back to the vector view. So it's a much faster zoom in and out performance that we can see here, and it also applies to when you're panning around. So I like to zoom in and out by pressing and holding the Z key, and then I like to pan around by holding down the space bar. But you can see how much faster everything is happening here in this new version, thanks to this smarter way of giving you previews while you are doing the navigation. And also worth mentioning that in Outline View, which you can get to with Command or Control Y, you also have now a GPU performance, which means that you get a much smoother transition between parts of your artwork while zooming in and out or panning around. And last but not least, another cool feature when you're working with fonts is the new font selector area, which has a lot of improvements, including that it automatically shows the selected text as a sample. Now we can also choose different options like typography and also even having the full alphabet there if we wanted to. We can also customize the size of this sample text here, so we can make it bigger, smaller, or medium size. We can also filter the available fonts on our computer based on their classification, like sans serif, serif, slab serif, scripts, so on and so forth. And you can also find the fonts that you have coming from Typekit very quickly. That's the activated fonts filter. So these are all the fonts that are synchronized from Typekit. And it's worth mentioning that you can have up to 100 of them at once. But of course you can replace them, so desynchronize some that you are not using anymore and get some new ones. If you want to get new Typekit fonts, again, now you don't have to leave Illustrator anymore. You can just click on Find More here on the top, and then this gives you a list of all the available fonts that you can synchronize. If you like one, all you have to do is to click on the little cloud icon to activate it. So this feature really helps if you are struggling finding fonts, because it gives you so many different ways of filtering your library and also finding new ones if you need them. But that's all I wanted to show you. So that was my five favorite new additions to CC 2019 in Illustrator. If you are interested to find out more about the new features in Photoshop and InDesign, make sure you check those videos out on our channel. Thanks a lot for watching, and I will see you in the next one.